Hi everybody, it's Eugene Lisho, and today I want to talk to you about the newly released FARO Freestyle. This is a new hand scanner that just got announced today, and pretty excited about it when I hear about hand scanners, because I think hand scanners have a lot of merit. A lot of you know that I do a bit of forensics work, and I think hand scanners haven't really made their way into the forensics world very strongly yet, so there hasn't been mass adoption, but I think that's the way of the future anyway. So I want to talk to you a little bit about the hardware and software and maybe give a little demo on the Freestyle here. So the first thing you'll notice is that it's quite unique in terms of its look. At the back here is the button for starting and stopping scans. And I'm sure if you can see that, but that's actually made of carbon fiber. So it's very rigid. It's a good, robust design. You'll see that there's four sets of optics here. At the bottom is the laser projector, and so that's actually what's going to be emitting the structured light pattern. In the center here is a color camera, and so that's going to be used to colorize the scan data or the point clouds, but it's also used for tracking. And then up on the two ends here, we have infrared cameras. Now these infrared cameras are going to be what is going to be sensing the structured light pattern. So what's unique about this particular unit is that in many other structured light systems you have one projector and one camera. Here we have two cameras that are sensing the pattern. So you actually have like a stereo pair that's focusing in on any particular point, and so through triangulation you can get into identifying a unique 3D point from the pattern. So I think that's pretty neat. This is tethered to the tablet. This is a Windows Surface Pro 3 tablet, just with a USB cable. I have been successful in extending that by about, I would say probably 3 meters or so. But I've been sort of working with it like this. The tablet itself, you can use a small micro SD card, like a 32 micro SD card, and it just goes in the back here. There's a little slot that where it goes in. At the back here, you see this, it's got this nice little holder that comes with it. So this is made of some kind of a Velcro, but it's very rigid. It doesn't feel like it's going to fall out of your hand, and it really secures it nicely. It's sort of an elastic type band on the back here. So that's the basic system. The software, and I'm not sure if you can see this or not, but this is actually scene capture. So it's a new version of the software, and the buttons are a little bit larger, so you can manipulate them by hand for use on a tablet, obviously. And the capture solution is really just for scanning, so you're not going to be doing a lot of processing and that sort of thing. Now there's another version of the software called Scene Process, and Scene Process you will in fact be able to do other things like registration and some other advanced filters and editing for the point clouds. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up a little scanning section, just what I have behind me. I have some targets and stuff, some old experiments that I was doing, and I'm going to scan it and we'll see how it goes. Okay, so to get started, what I'll do is I'll actually close this and go back to the home screen. And this is normally from where you would start from. If there was any project, they would show up in the screen. But all I need to do is actually hit the start button on the scanner itself, on the hand scanner, and it'll jump into a new project and everything else. So I'm going to move away from the video and I'm going to start this now. So hopefully you'll still be able to hear me. I'll speak a bit louder. So I'm going to hit the scan button here, and this should start up with a new project. And as soon as it starts, or is able to track, you'll see it'll do the split screen. There it goes. So it's captured. Wherever you're seeing the colored area on the right there, that's where it's actually picking up points. And if I'm just moving around here, you see how fast I'm moving. I'm actually not even looking at what I'm scanning here. I'm actually looking at the camera and the monitor, or the tablet, I should say. Moving relatively steadily. I mean, you don't want to be too shaky. So I'm just moving over this. So you see I'm picking up a lot of points on the open case there. That's actually a total station. What's a total station, right? So I'm moving here. You see in an area where I get with less tracking, it starts giving me a little warning. But I've got pretty much the section that I want to get. I'm just going to go down to the bottom corner again to make sure I've got that area filled in. And I want to get part of the floor as well, because I want to show you something. So I'm getting part of the floor here. That's good enough. So I'm going to stop it here.
So I'm not sure how long that took, if that was 30 seconds or so. Let me put the scanner down and I'll move back into position so I can manipulate these scans here and you can see them. Just give it a second. So it's saving the scans right now, and once it's done that, it'll just refresh the screen so I can manipulate it here. So that's what I'm going to do right now. So I'm just going to move this, and it works just like a tablet. You can move it around and stuff. So it's not bad. It's a fairly clean scan. You'll see at the bottom here, if I just level it off, it's fairly level there. What I can do is, because there's no inclinometer in the hand scanner, there's a button here for hand scanning. So I'm going to click on that, and all I need to do is hit 3 points on the ground that I want to call my my ground plane. And I think I missed one of those points, actually. Let me try that again so that it's probably a little bit better. Hit level. Now I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. Okay. So now I'm sort of down, and I've got what I need. So that is pretty much it. Now this is just the capture. So what you're looking at is the raw captured scan. I haven't done anything to it. I haven't done any white balance. I haven't done any filtering for noise or anything else. So there are a number of things that you will be able to do later on. You'll notice some things here on the under the options. It has a flash. So there is a flash on the unit itself to help with low light conditions. I didn't have it on. I have enough light here as it is. You can save to the USB. There's a small SD card, a micro SD card in the Windows tablet, so you can have it automatically saved to that location, or you can save to the tablet itself. Depends on what you want to do. And you can adjust the depth range and stuff like that. So I'm just leaving it on the settings that I had before. Let me close that off. Here. And pivot rotation, you've got that. You click on a point, you can adjust the pivot point rotation. And so, you know, there's a measure button. That's kind of cool. You know, if you want to measure between 2 points, we can do that as well. So you can take measurements while you're in the field. So it's a simple capture solution, and it's named capture exactly for that, because that's really what it's going to be doing for you. But once you get into scene process, you'll be able to do a lot more, and you'll be able to tie these in with scans from a focus or a scanner. So that's pretty much what I wanted to show for now. I'm sure there's going to be a lot more examples coming in the days ahead. And I hope you enjoyed that. And thanks very much.